This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a really big show tonight. An enormous plane.
The A380 is the world's largest passenger plane.
A huge undertaking.
We're breaking the world record for the largest paper airplane.
A whale of a heart.
Big enough that a grown man can climb into it.
And one burger to rule them all.
12 patties, 24 pieces of bacon, 24 pieces of American cheese.
Plus, tales from the limo world.
You must have stories of...
Oh, yeah.
And get a load of this painting.
It is longer than the Empire State Building is tall.
This is big.
Next on Chronicle. For a small state, Massachusetts is a heavyweight. Brimfield is home to the world's largest outdoor antique show. Chicopee's Mavis Wanchick snagged the largest single Powerball jackpot in U.S. history, $758 million.
Benvenuto Crucolo!
Every year, Concord draws a crowd to welcome a big cheese, 400 pounds of Crucolo. The Boston Public Library is the largest in New England, with the third largest collection in the country.
Okay.
And in Cambridge, Elsa Dorfman is still clicking giant Polaroid photos on one of five original cameras. In Sunderland stands the largest American sycamore, or buttonball tree, in the state. Girth, 25 feet. Try to get your arms around that. And now, landing at Logan, the Super Jumbo A380, seven stories high at the tail, a wingspan nearly the size of a football field. British Airways is the first and so far only airline flying this mega plane into Boston. Airport manager Joe Zanakis.
When it comes in, there's just a buzz that this aircraft creates that I haven't seen since maybe Concorde. It's a special plane, something we're very proud of.
Talk about big. The A380 is the world's largest passenger plane. Bigger than a 747, bigger than a C-5 cargo plane. This is big.
With two full wide-body decks, the A380 is the only flying double-decker. Depending on design, it can carry up to 800 passengers. This plane seats 469 in four classes. Crew size, 22.
Somehow it doesn't actually even feel like an aircraft right here. It feels a little more like a boat or maybe just a house.
It's designed in a special way.
Wow, first class here.
It is a wow. The wow factor is in effect. We've got 14 of these beautiful first class suites, enhanced padding on the seats. We've got about 1,200 hours of entertainment.
You get used to this.
The biggest benefit of this aircraft for the passenger is the light colors, the airy cabin. The air filtration system changes the air in the aircraft every 3 minutes. When you have an aircraft of this size and you can cater to 469 people in four different cabins, you've got to get it right in every cabin.
So what's it like to fly the biggest passenger plane in the world? Captain Mike Blythe, a 27-year veteran with British Airways, admits it's a head-turner.
But I spent 12 years before this in short haul on 320s, and no one was too interested in me arriving or departing at that stage. Where you really notice the difference is when you're on the ground and you've got these huge wings, and that's where you need to be a little bit careful when you're maneuvering around tight areas. One of the things that we get commented a lot from the passengers is they're not aware of the size of the aircraft when they're on board. And in fact, it's an incredibly quiet aircraft. We've had people asking their cabin crew before whether we're airborne yet, and we took off 10 minutes ago. It's quite environmentally friendly as well, so it's quite an economical way of getting a large number of people from A to B.
Getting large numbers of people on and off the plane requires wider gates with double jet bridges, one for each deck.
When we first decided to bring the A380 into Boston, we approached the airport authority, and we partnered together, and we really delivered an incredible product. The first thing we had to do was build extension to the terminal, which created three A380 gates. And with that comes this lounge to meet the need for capacity and also match the style and the luxury of the A380.
The centerpiece is this horseshoe bar with skyline view. An in-house kitchen provides fine dining.
The key to this lounge is actually the ability to board our passengers that are in the lounge from the lounge. Boston is a very important market for us. It's actually the second most frequently serviced airport that we operate to outside of New York. It's very important for us to hit the right level of service and luxury to give it. I think the A380 did that.
Personally, how do you like
flying? I love it. It's the highlight of my career.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely.
As boarding time draws near for the return trip across the pond, the volume of passengers at gate E12 is a sure sign this is a big aircraft, 83 rows. Staff and Ann King were surprised to learn their seats are on the world's largest passenger plane.
That's pretty exciting. I know now. We came walking down the aisle. I said, look at that thing over there. It's huge. That's first I saw of it.
British Airways flight 212, service London Heathrow. Boarding group number 2 at gate number 12.
It's going to be an exciting trip.
Oh, wow. And we heard from staff and Ann King, and they shared their thoughts about the flight.
Yeah, they said they could hardly tell they were flying. Much like the captain said, it's very, very quiet. There's little sense of movement. They had one complaint, though, which was they wished the flight had been longer because they wanted to enjoy the luxury of the 380 a little bit longer.
Oh, just sit they really back liked it. And yeah. Relax. All right, next, we have just one question. Do people actually eat this?
Taking on the Eagles Challenge.